A new investigation by the New York Times has found that Clarence Thomas, justice on the Supreme Court of the United States, is somehow even more corrupt than we had already learned in just the last few months. Because it turns out that Clarence Thomas has been receiving gifts from Republican millionaires and billionaires for literal decades, going all the way back to when he first got on the Supreme Court in 1991. But this investigation actually went further back. Because it wasn't just in 1991 when Clarence Thomas got on the bench that he started getting these gifts. That just happens to be the year that he was brought into the Horatio Alger Association of Distinguished Americans. Big fancy name for a group that is effectively nothing more than a bunch of wealthy Republicans who like to buy influence in Washington, D.C. That's what that group is. A group that has largely operated in the shadows, a group that most people have never even heard of. But it's a big club, and you ain't in it, and this group has a lot of money and a lot of influence. And according to this investigation from the New York Times, those wealthy Republicans as part of that group began showering Clarence Thomas with gifts and trips. But as I said, it didn't just start in 1991. That's just when he joined that organization. Because according to the report, back in the 1980s, Clarence Thomas, while then just a federal judge, had wealthy Republicans pay for a trip for him and his girlfriend to go to the Bahamas. A few years later, one of his wealthy friends actually paid for his wedding to his wife, Jenny Thomas. All of this, of course, before he was even on the Supreme Court. So Clarence Thomas has actually been corrupted by this big money Republican machine since before he even made it onto the Supreme Court. But of course, once he got on there, once he was a part of this organization, he started receiving even more gifts, more trips. Many of them were, of course, not reported because Clarence Thomas effectively stopped reporting these kinds of things in the early 2000s after the Los Angeles Times ran a lengthy piece talking about all the trips and gifts that he was receiving. He decided after he was exposed, he just wasn't going to report them anymore. So what this tells us, of course, is that Clarence Thomas has been corrupted for what, 40 years almost? 40 years, this man has been corrupted by big money Republican donors. And he still sits on that court today in a lifetime appointment with virtually no accountability. I mean, I can't even say virtually no accountability. There is no accountability. Because even as these stories were coming out of Clarence Thomas, again, starting back a couple months ago, what happened then? We had a slew of court decisions from Thomas and, of course, some of the other corrupted Republicans on that bench, stripping us, the American public, of our rights. Stripping us of the gifts we had been given by this administration, specifically student loan debt forgiveness. These wholly corrupted, disgusting human beings, violating every code of ethics a human being could have, stripping us of our rights. And there is nothing we can do about it. Now, we have had Democratic lawmakers in both the House and the Senate. They've come out, they have called out Chief Justice John Roberts, saying, come and talk to us. We want to have hearings. We want to find out what the hell is going on at that Supreme Court. But in the House, it's not going to go anywhere because you got Republicans running the show. And in the Senate, well, we've had calls, but that's it. This cannot continue. The entire Supreme Court must be dismantled. And I know in order to do that, we have to, you know, amend the Constitution. And I know it'll never happen, okay? I'm not living in this optimist fantasy of what the United States should be. But I'm telling you of what should happen. Because that Supreme Court cannot be trusted. It cannot. Every bit of Judge Jackson, Justice Jackson, she can be trusted, right? The newest judge on there, you're good to go. Beyond that, they all gotta go. They all have to go. Because otherwise, we're gonna sit here, we're gonna keep getting more stories of this level of corruption from people like Clarence Thomas, and all we're gonna do is sit here and get more and more pissed off, unable to do anything about it. So if Congress is not gonna act, if the Senate is not gonna act, then vote every one of them out. I don't care what party they're in. But if you're not going to take the necessary steps to hold this Supreme Court accountable, then you don't deserve to have a job in Washington, D.C. anymore. Thanks for watching, everyone, and well, here comes the awkward part at the end of the video where I ask you to like, comment, and share, and subscribe for more content from Ring of Fire. Also, you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks, including early access videos and exclusive videos. Check out the link in the description.